morning, everybody. It's, what day is it today? Wednesday. And I'm very excited to be doing a little Instagram takeover on this account. Just having my coffee and dance party like Jonathan Van Ness. And then I'm going to get started on all sorts of takeover fun. We've got a giveaway lined up. We've got a live definitely coming at some point today. Loads and loads of fun. And I'm going to put a question as usual, so you can ask me anything you like and let me know what you want to see on today's takeover. Okay, bye! Hey guys, so those of you who know me will know that I'm a bagel expert, right? Now the key thing to the excellent bagel is a good butter-like spread. If you aren't vegan, you can go for a full-on butter, makes it delicious, or this is a little plant-based spread here that I've got. Now, you must put this on before your peanut butter, okay? It's essential. You need it. It makes it moist. And it makes it nice and melty, okay? We want the melty butter on before the peanut butter, okay? Otherwise, it's way too dry. It's literally gonna, your mouth is gonna be just full of like peanut butter, you know? So need that butter on first. Let me show you. See? Melty. Next step, head in there with the peanut butter and go for it with this bad boy. You don't need to be stingy. Let your freak flag fly with this sucker. Look, I mean, hang on, I'll show you. Like, I'm eating a lot. It's really not low fat, but it's essential for the flavour that I'm going for, okay? And we spread that on nice and thick. Okay, maybe that was slightly excessive. I was showing off for the camera, you know. But I'm gonna use it on both bagels and that should even it out. Okay, here we go. It's just so delicious, guys. It's so blooming delicious. Okay, so that I've put the peanut butter on, now I'm going to go in there with the banana as well. You don't have to go in there with a banana. This is a perfectly good finished product here. Bam. Okay, but I'm gonna top it off with a banana. Oh my god, this whole thing? Swear that. Funnily enough, we actually have a song called What I Know Now that's all about things that I would kind of say to my younger self, and it might be being released in the next few months. I don't know.
Thank you very much. Well, yes, it's just because basically I'm a massive Harry Potter nerd. However, I don't condone JK Rowling's recent behaviour, and we've collectively made a decision that I wrote Harry Potter.
Literally like a week. it's all come together quite quickly, but I literally can't tell you how excited I am. So me and my housemate Lucy Lou are about to do a horrendous workout that's gonna kill us from Tess Cadler. Would highly recommend, but also you will die.
That didn't turn out exactly how your mom and dad wanted you to be. This is starting 40 something. Well, raise up your glass and laugh like. This is starting 50 something. Hell, you're halfway there, baby. Take it to the head. Mom and dad try to hide the world. Said the world's just too big for a little girl.
Sorry, just laughing at my hair.
This is a look. Anyway, I'm just about to announce the little giveaway that I've got lined up. I still can't get over my hair. What's going on? Anyway, I'm going to be putting the info for the giveaway that I'll be holding in the next story, so tap along. Oh my god. That would be the best. I'd say like 5k. 5k signatures and we'll get on it. Right, girls?
Gay rights. Happy Pride.
So our producer wanted us all to go on a big Zoom call, but I was actually teaching that day, so I couldn't go on it. But someone in my class recorded the call for me and just sent it through. And I was literally sat on my own in my bedroom, like, yeah, and I'm definitely going to need them. I couldn't remember my lines pre-corona, so God knows what they are now. Oh my God, amazing. Can't wait to see you there. It's a tie between getting to see my amazing queens again and getting to perform in venues that like are so random and I would never get to perform in otherwise. Actually, I'm highly logical, which allows me to look past extraneous detail and perceive clearly that which others overlook. It's gonna be both of us. I just realised that I spelled Hermione wrong in my previous Insta story and I'm like coming to terms with my anger over it, but I apologise. I hate it. I think it's horrible. She's ruined for so many people what used to be a safe space. You know, growing up I was really badly bullied and Harry Potter like kind of took me out of that place, and she's ruined that for so many people. However, I am of the opinion that these stories aren't for her anymore, they're for us. She doesn't get an opinion on anything in the Harry Potter fandom anymore. Also, gang, I am doing a sunny afternoon workshop this Sunday at 3 p.m. It's £7 per person, and you just have to send the payment over to my PayPal link, which I'll put as a swipe up in the next story, and then with your email address in the reference, and then I will send you all the info over for the class. It's going to be a really good fun one. Bring lots of water, it's a killer routine, but yeah, it's going to be a good one. They certainly think so. Also, gang, I've been getting a few questions of things that I've been reading in lockdown, and I'm quite a bookworm, so I thought I'd do just a little. So I read this in lockdown, which is absolutely fantastic, and I to be able to win an argument, so that's a good one. Turning the Tide on Plastic, that's kind of a pick up put down one, so I haven't finished that yet. Loved this, absolutely loved it. Both of the Sally Rooneys I've actually reread in lockdown. I've read them before, but I loved them so much I read them again. This is fantastic, really really brilliant book. I'm halfway through this. Loved this. I love Eleanor Oliphant. This was not amazing, but I still liked it. I've read that before, but I read it again. And then, these are my currents. Oh, there's some Harry Potters. As I was saying, these are my currents. I'm halfway through this at the moment, and it's brilliant. It's very educational, and it's just a necessary read. And actually, it's not very long. Like, you can probably, I mean, I'm there, and reading it for maybe the past couple of nights, so yeah, you can get through it quite quickly. And these are like my next up on the list. I've actually started this one. I started that one maybe halfway through lockdown, but moved on to this one. But I will be going back to it because, again, I love to win an argument. Oh my god, 100% a walk on the beach, a walk in the woods. I think I'd be really scared. I'm a bit of a wuss, I won't lie. My parents got it for me from, I want to say Links of London. I think it is Links of London where they got it for me. It was a Christmas present.
Down you crazy child and take the phone off the hook and disappear for a while. It's alright, you can't afford to lose a day or two. Ooh, when will you? Not you.
Me?
It's time to announce the giveaway winner, and the prize is right here. So, the person who won the giveaway is, I'm going to wait till I have another story, Rebecca. And I'm going to put her name right here. She won it. Nailed it, Rebecca. So I will DM you, probably from my personal account, and I will get your address and everything, and I'll send this cutie little Seymour stagey pop over to you. Hello guys, I am signing off from my takeover today, but thank you so much for having me. I hope you've enjoyed it. Lucy has certainly enjoyed it. Lucy.
Oh.
She's my biggest fan, can I say. But yeah, I've loved having a chat with you all, and I hope that you've enjoyed that was a stroke. I hope that you've enjoyed it as well.
A stroke.
Make sure you go follow me if you haven't already.